How much is all that?
4.35, Governor.
4.35, eh? Right down to the last quarter of a mile. There we are. No, my son, you keep that. You deserve it.
A nice tour we had all around London.
Lurking. You all right, Bill? Oh, dear. What you done?
I need help, Arthur.
Come inside, we'll have a nice drink.
No, I want a lift, Arthur. Can you drive me somewhere?
Well, in my state, I'm boozed. I've been to a function. Some of the chaps from the lodge. Come inside and tell me all about it.
I need a lift now, Arthur. Oh, I've done my leg in, you see.
Are we friends, Billy? Are we mates? You will get a lift, my son. You will get a ride to the ends of the earth. Lean on me.
I think it's really clever you being into yoga and everything.
Yes, right.
Hey, have you got lodgers?
Hey?
Is someone out there?
Terry, open up. Open up, Terry!
Shh, Bill. I'm asleep.
Very important. Terry! Open up! Oh, what have you come as?
I'm sorry, Arthur. Listen, mate.
He got his kung fu gear on.
I've got something else on in there, right?
Yeah, look, you know Billy Gilpin, don't you? Well, Billy needs a favour. Yeah, well, let's come in. Come on, Bill, come in.
Well, go over there, then.
Over here, Bill.
Oh, shut up. Keep the noise down.
You want a drink, Billy?
No, thanks, Arthur.
Now, look. I promised Billy. I said if there's one fella who will not let you down...
I've got a bird in there.
I will explain it to her.
You won't. It's taken me 3 hours to get her there.
You think I can't charm her into staying another 3 hours?
Look, Terry, I'm sorry, but I really need this favour.
Terry, a friend, Terry.
Good night.
Your charm must have penetrated through the bleeding wall.
Not too fast, eh? We don't want to get a pull. You're right there, Squire. Ain't been road tax for months.
Don't you want some music?
No, quite honestly.
I like that one, friend. Because you've got to have friends. Old Klingman and Linnard.
What?
They said it. I mean, the bird sings it, but it's old Klingman and Linnard wrote it down. I won't forget this. The way I see it, a friend is a guy, you look him up in the middle of the night, and he'll help you. No questions, nothing. See? You haven't asked, have you?
Ask what?
How come pretty Billy's got a bruise on his face and a bad leg? How come he wants a lift in the middle of the night?
I don't want to know.
Well, that's good. Anyway, I've given Arthur an address. He'll see you well looked after.
I thought it was all down to friendship.
People I've been with, you see, they don't understand that sort of thing. Slags. And the filth. No way are they going to believe my story.
And I don't want to hear it, Billy.
Me, I'm a champagne man. I just love that old bubbly. Up and away. But then I get these donors, see? Really down. So they put me on these tablets. suppose they think I might top myself.
Nearly always cracking jokes, me.
You ask Arthur. Tell you what, we meet up again, we'll split a bottle of champers, right?
Yeah, right.
How are you going to book in here without any bags or anything?
Guy's a friend. No friends, Terry. You ain't got a life.
Terence McCann.
I'd never have guessed without seeing that.
Yeah, you must have seen quite a few in your time.
No. It's the Marks and Spencer executive line suit that does it. You've got no right breaking in here.
Breaking in? We were kindly allowed access by your associate.
I was having a kip.
Shall we take a ride down the road?
What if I say no?
That would be silly, really. Because all we want to do is have a talk with you.
Thanks, Arthur.
Wherever I go, Terry, I see dirt. Wherever I listen, I hear lies. And I've always had a kind of faith in you. No trouble for 5 years now. I thought you were a walking testimony to the reformative powers of the British penal system. And then, suddenly, you're running a minicab service for nasty villains like Billy Gilpin.
I gave him a lift. That's no crime, is it?
Well, it depends. I mean, say two scoundrels walk out of a shop with a string of pearls that doesn't belong to them and somebody gives them a lift. That's a crime, isn't it?
Eh? Yes.
And what about attempted murder? Is that a crime in your book? Or aiding and abetting the escape of a man wanted for attempted murder?
I don't know what he did.
I just told you.
Yeah, well, he never mentioned it to me.
What did he talk about then?
Friends.
Like who?
Well, Klingman and Linhart or something.
Who are they?
They wrote a song, apparently.
Are you trying to be funny?
No, that's what we talked about.
And Lord Ingrave.
What's that, a boozer?
He may be, for all I know. It's also the name of the man that Billy tried to murder.
Well, if he did, he never mentioned it to me.
Listen, Terry. I'm not asking you to be supergrass. I am advising a slightly more cooperative attitude. I mean, attempted murder on my patch, and I get somebody, either the guy who did it, or the guy who helped him to get away. Am I coming through loud and clear?
I've got the top one, have I?
Looks like it, don't it?
It's okay by me. I've had plenty of practice. I've just done a 5 in Durham. Only out 2 weeks. Bastards down here, they don't give you a chance. Attempted robbery, they said. Black and blue all over, they give me a right kicking on the way in. Still stuff them. I say stuff them.
What are you in for yourself?
Not a lot.
I've been everywhere myself. Maidenhead, Hull. I've even been up in Peterhead. I done pottery and carpet weaving up there.
And they nicked you for it?
No, inside. Occupational therapy. Bloody cold up there, you know. You don't say much, do you?
Don't get a lot of chance with you.
Don't mind me, I'm an outgoing sort of fella. I like getting on with people and that.
I'll suss that.
Oh, straight, I am. But, like, you seem worried, you know, depressed. First time in, is it? Don't worry.
Get it off my chest.
Yeah, why not? Best way. What do they call you? They call me Colin. Big Col, usually.
Yeah, I know you.
You do? You heard of me?
Oh, yeah. Probably end up my best pal, won't you? Then in a fit of depression and remorse, I'll tell you my life story, what I've done, how I did it. And the next time I see you, I'll be in the witness box swearing my life away.
Hey, you got it all wrong. I just want to be your friend.
Great. But I've had enough of friends for today. Okay.
Don't go nipping off to Mallorca. We may want you in again.
You got me to thank for getting you out of there. I got you to thank for getting me in there. It's nice, isn't it? Look, me walking around dressed like this at this time of day.
Don't worry. All your friends, I think you've been to a tailor's for a fitting.
Fit up, more likely. When I think of the dinners I've been to with some of those people, D.I., who should be nameless, I got him a deep freeze, giveaway price. Steel.
Well, it was, wasn't it?
Beside the point. They're not only getting younger, they're getting stroppier. Taxi! Yeah, they're just as bad. Not wearing a yashmak, they don't want to know.
So what about Billy?
Well, you can never tell with him. He might be doing a bit of cross-channel swimming.
In the motor, he was talking about topping himself.
Well, I hope he makes a phone call about our dough before he does it.
Oh, you're charming, aren't you? I thought he was a mate of yours.
So, I'll cry a little. I still want the dough. Quick sauna, change of attire, and we'll nip over to Lady Ingrave's.
Who?
Lady Anna Claire Ingrave. Who is?
Who is? The wife of the geezer Billy tried to murder, right?
That is their personal private business. But our wages, that's something else, isn't it?
Taxi! And I'll see you later.
Yeah. Wouldn't be Terence McCann, would it? Don't do a runner, we're not old, Bill.
Hard to tell these days.
No aggravation. Someone to talk to you.
Same pattern, oh. That's what they said. Kept me in for bleeding hours.
Bobby Altman gets to the point much quicker.
Who?
A good friend of Billy Gilpin.
I knew that word had come into it somewhere.
Eh?
Friends. I mean Billy. Very into friends.
How much has he done?
On his fourth mile.
Do a bit of jogging, do you, Terry?
Now and again.
Squash, tennis, badminton?
No.
Work out in the gym?
Bit.
I remember you fighting, badly handled. I made you a mug. Come a long way. Now you're an even bigger mug.
Somebody get a jug of fresh orange juice.
You work for Arthur Daly?
Eh?
You work for Arthur Daly, don't you?
Sort of.
You know what he is? He's Two Bob. He's a financial midget. Try the speedball, Terry.
No, I'm all right.
He said, try it.
See, I run 4 miles, I take a shower, I sit down, and my pulse is normal. That's because I've got a very slow heartbeat, 56 to the minute. Athletes half my age would like a pulse rate like that. That's what makes me such a calm and rational man. Know when it quickens? Talk about money and it quickens. Talk about money that's been stolen from me, and it races. Billy Gilpin stole money from me, and you helped him get away.
Billy's dead.
You believe that?
Well, I don't know. They reckon he just walked into the water.
Bullshit! With 70 grand, he could walk underwater.
Look, all I did was give him a lift.
What does that make you?
It makes me the geezer who gave him a lift, and that's all.
Makes you an accomplice. It makes you the man that helped steal money from me.
Now, look.
Don't tell me look! I'll tell you look! I say I'm excited. Now, I'm angry. And what happens? My heart starts racing. The Ayatollah. You heard of him?
Yeah.
Well, I'm a fan. You steal, you get your hand cut off. You steal from me, and never mind about the referendum. Never mind about free votes in the House of Commons. You steal from me, and that is the return of capital punishment.
Yeah, well, I plead diminished responsibility.
What's that supposed to mean?
I didn't know what it was all about.
Oh, you didn't wonder what was in his little Gucci case?
He didn't have a case.
So his pockets was bulging?
No. His eye was bulging and he had a dodgy leg.
Oh, and you're St. John's ambulance. Anybody a little out of sorts and you give him a helping hand. Big pal of yours, is he?
I've never even met him before.
Can you believe that, chaps? This guy's terrific. The last of the English gents.
I was just doing a favour.
Oh, that's nice. You do a favour. That's a nice thing to do. I may even believe you. Now, you're in my house. You've seen the gym. I've got staff. Stuart. Come down from Scotland. 10 bob in his sporran. Now, he's well-dressed. Lives well. He's got a gold DuPont lighter. And he don't even smoke. You know what a bearer bond is? Of course you don't. They're like money. You take them into a bank and they pay you out face value. That's what we've been doing. France, Switzerland, Germany. Don't ask how we got them, but we're selling them. You need a bit of front for that. You need to look right. That's why Pretty Billy's on the firm. So, temptation falls in his path. If you don't have the money on him, somebody's looking after it. Logical? How'd he come to you?
Arthur brought him.
two and two, Terry. You need a pocket calculator for that?
Of course you don't.
Go and tell Arthur. Tell him I want my money back. Tell him if I don't get it, he's a dead man. I could punch holes in you, Terry. Know why? Alan and George would be holding you down. Tell Arthur.
Bobby Altman? Ha ha, don't make me laugh. I used to know him out at the East End. He used to thieve off thieves.
Yeah, well, that's not all that easy, is it?
Kill me? How's he gonna kill me?
I should imagine he'd have a variety of ways. He'd have ways other people haven't even thought of.
Yeah. Well, you better stick around then, hadn't you? Yeah.
Lady Ingrave?
Yes?
I'm Arthur Daly.
Don't mind beluga.
Oh, my favourite caviar, as it happens.
Beluga, shush. You better come in.
Yeah, of course.
Well?
Yeah, well, we'll be getting along.
Terry? It is Terry, isn't it?
Yeah.
I'd like to thank you for what you did for Billy.
Oh, I didn't realise you were friends. Have you spoken to him?
Yes. He called me from the hotel. He was very grateful.
It's nice to know, isn't it? By the way, how's your husband?
Very ill. He may even die.
That was a bit strong, wasn't it?
Are you kidding? Her old man dies. Billy might be dead. Where does that leave me? Or you, for that matter?
I'm not worried about Bobby Altman.
Should be.
Why?
His roller's coming down the road.
Seen us?
Don't think so.
You better make yourself scarce.
What about you?
No, I'll stay here and see who else they've invited to the party.
Yeah. Well, take care of yourself. You sure they've gone in?
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you.
Walk your dog, lady.
What do you want?
I think it's what we call owning up time.
I have nothing to say to you.
Yeah, well, I've got a few things to say to you.
Please leave me alone.
You haven't been exactly straight.
If you don't go, I shall call the police.
Oh, yeah? And what will you tell them? All about pretty Billy? Your friend, Bobby Altman? How you just paid Arthur and me off?
What exactly do you want?
Well, how about a little drink for a start, eh?
Excuse me, what ward is Lord Ingrave in?
That's a private ward, it's down to the right. On the bottom.
Okay, cheers.
Thank you. They won't let anyone else see him.
Did you tell him about me and Arthur? Listen.
Oh, what are you doing here?
I'm a friend of the family, suddenly.
Mr. McCann wanted to see my husband.
Did he? Very considerate of you, Terry. I believe he's making a bit of a recovery.
He's much better, thank you.
Good. In fact, good news all around. They just fished Billy Gilpin's body out of the sea.
Somebody identified the body?
Oh, yeah. His sister's just been down there. Tide carried him well out. Fella thought he'd hooked into a nice bit of Dover soul and comes up with Billy instead. He didn't seem too bad considering. Always was a good-looking boy. I was just going to let Lord Ingrave know, m'lady.
Thank you.
Come on.
If you'll pardon the expression, Terry, this sort of lets you off the hook, doesn't it?
Do you believe him?
Why not?
Billy was a very good swimmer.
He was going to set up a fake suicide, you mean? So all that stuff he gave me about depression and tablets and topping himself was all a load of crap.
I suppose so.
Just there to set me up as part of the great conspiracy.
I don't know.
Well, hold on. What do you know?
He was going to swim out to sea for about a mile. A friend was going to pick him up in a launch. They were going to land in Normandy. Another friend was going to drive him to Paris.
Must be really great having all them friends, eh? Come on.
I hope you're well insured, Arthur. You've just done our near side wing.
And he didn't leave a message for me? No, no, that's all right, no. No, I'll hang around here, he'll probably sharp. Yeah. Yeah, cheers. Ta-da.
Excuse me, pal.
Give us a gin and tonic, a large one, and a lager when you've got a minute, please.
Oh, nice. You might have rung me.
I meant to, honestly. But, what about tomorrow, eh?
Yeah, any luck, I'll probably be out.
Jane!
Valerie!
Yeah, put it on the slate, will you? Slice of lemon, all right? All they got in the way of fruit.
Fine. So this is it, eh? The natural habitat of Terry McCann.
Yeah. I'm surprised Billy didn't bring you to places like this.
He was a champagne man.
Oh, that's right, yeah. He kept on telling me. But this is where he'd belong, though. I mean, what was he? A little thief. Now, you see that geezer at the bar? No, he's a thief. Good one, as it happens. Now him, he'll steal and lie, but he would never land a friend in trap.
And you're one of the same species, are you?
Except I don't steal.
You beat people up for a living.
Who told you that? No, I escort drunks to the door. Sometimes I look after people who can't look after themselves. But I never cause trouble. I try and stop it.
And how do you recognize it?
Well, it's not difficult after a while. You soon come to recognise whether it's just the booze talking. Geezers going on and on about how many fights they've had. Well, they're no threat at all. Then there's the other mob. Cold blue eyes, smart suits, think they should have been in Day of the Jackal. Well, they're terrific at shouting at birds in the typing pool. Now, in my game, you don't look for trouble. You just keep an eye out for the guys who are going to start it.
And you're always right.
Right, me? No, you're kidding. Now, you see, there's one mob who you can never recognise. Nutters.
What do they look like?
Well, that's the trouble, you see. They look like anybody. They look like you, Duchess.
Bob. Bit of a misunderstanding, eh?
Is there? You look older, Arthur.
Well, time marches on and all that. You're looking well.
I said not to hurt him.
Well, you got Lippy in the motor.
I was expecting 70 grand.
No, you got it all wrong, Bob. You see, look, all I did was...
Yeah. I know, I heard it all from Terry. Did he give you my message?
Yeah.
You thought a few nights at the hotel and they'd forget all about it. And then you heard that Billy really was dead. And you thought, hello, suddenly it's Christmas.
I haven't heard nothing.
Don't lie! I can stand a thief. I can't stand a liar. You haven't changed. You were two Bob in the old days, you're still two Bob. Actually, you've upset me. I'm sorry about that. I said no violence! Don't hurt him! See, now I've got to calm down.
Oh, well, I'm sorry about that.
Shut up! Give him a camp bed and a lilo. We'll make an early start in the morning, Arthur.
Bob?
So you and your old man were the front for Altman, eh? Poncing all round Europe selling off dodgy bearer bonds.
More or less.
God dear, I bet Altman loved that.
Well, of course he did. New money craves old respectability.
Then why screw it all up? By falling for pretty Billy?
He was very good company.
Oh. That's what my mum said about our old Labrador.
Then I'd probably have liked him.
Yeah, you probably would. He was the right little scallywag and all. What are you, Duchess? A villain's groupie?
I loved Billy.
Maybe you did. But he ain't coming back, is he? And he don't need the money anymore.
And does Altman?
Oh, not many. Listen, he needs it more than, well, what do you call it? The old respectability. He needs it enough, Duchess, to put you in a hospital bed next to your husband. If I tell him about you and Billy.
And would you?
Oh, yes. I've got a friend too. Now come on, Duchess. The money.
Bit warm in that cellar, was it, Arthur?
No, it's okay.
You look a mess. Get your clothes off.
Eh?
Undress.
What for?
Because I said so.
Look, honest to God, you got it all wrong. Go to my house, turn it upside down, you won't find any money there. Well, obviously, you'll find a bob or two, but you won't find your money.
I believe you. Because you've hid it somewhere else.
On my boy Terry's life.
Clothes off.
What are you going to do?
Oh, I got it. Arthur think it's torture. Strip off. Electrodes on the private parts. What do you think we are? Some nasty little South London team? This is Happy Hampstead, Arthur. London's lung, somebody called it. That's why I live up here. Because it's healthy. Give him his gear. Go for a run.
Joking. I don't run.
We're about the same age, aren't we? And I'm in perfect condition. But you, Arthur, a bit flabby, too much of the old vodka, still smoke, late nights, chasing after young birds. You could lose 2 stone, no bother. Change your whole life, change your outlook.
Thank you.
Now what a run does for you, clears the mind. Business problems, whoosh, float away. And with the mind clear, helps the memory. Things come back to you. You'd be surprised. See, I've got a Cartier watch. I couldn't find it. I've shouted at the dear wife. I've even come to the point where I thought the lads had nicked it, or the au pair. I went out for a run, and what happened? Suddenly I remembered. I'd left it in the tweed jacket. Tweed jacket. See, that's what a run did for me. Found me a couple of grand's worth of watch. There you are. You look fitter already. Tell you what, Arthur, you could do a runner.
But this jogging, it's not my game.
Of course it is. On your mark, Arthur. Get set, go. See, it's quite easy, isn't it?
Yeah. Okay.
Don't approve of this, you know, if you're out of condition. Never too much, too soon. Some fellas, you know, their legs go first like old fighters. Yeah, then their lungs begin to tighten.
Hey. Bobby's taking him over the cross-country bit now.
Suppose you could say he's going to run him into the ground.
Yeah. We better turn around.
Read the statistics. Heart attacks. You drop dead, Arthur. What do they find? Just another old jogger. The money, Arthur.
No.
Then run. You've been abusing your body.
You're killing me. And I don't know.
Nice, big, deep breaths. And you can tell me. See? Great what a little exercise can do for you, innit?
Innit it just.
Mm.
Aren't you going to count it, then?
No, Terry, no. No, you've got an honest face. Leave it out, Stuart. He'll slaughter you.
Come on, mate, you're all right. Come on, up you get. Come on, come on. There you go, that's it. There you
go. Terry, I'm a goner. The watch. You have the watch. Look after her indoors. Don't tell her too much.
Come on, you're all right. Get your feet on your plates. Come on, that's it. Good deep breaths. Come on, come on.
Oh, the minute I'm going. Oh, I need the kiss of life.
Oh, I'm sorry about that, mate. Listen, have a cigar, eh? Come on.
Oh, Terry. You're a pal.
Yeah, mate. Where would we be without her, mate? Come on, come on.